Bright Entertainment brings you the biggest, brightest, and best lineup of characters ever. Switch on to Hours of Fun for kids of all ages. Out now on video and DVD.
Postman Pat and Jess the Cat are back in two brand new adventures. Hop on board with all your favorite characters and meet Pat's new friends, Ajay the Station Master and his family. Postman Pat's Magic Christmas, out now on video and DVD.
Why is Clifford so big? Why does he live on Burwell Island? And who are his friends? Well, now you can find out in Clifford, the Big Red Dog.
Ooh. We can Cubby-Dooby-Doo, we can Cubby-Dooby-Doo.
Castle and Other Tales is the fantastic new video featuring more adventures of Merlin the Magical Puppy and all his friends in Sandy Bay, with the brilliant voices of Martin Clunes and Dawn French. Only a wish away. Own it on video today.
It's fun, it's creative, it's fingertips. Now on video and DVD. It's the smash hit show that brings you great makes in easy-to-follow steps. It's
everything you could ever want to make and do right in your fingertips.
If you're looking for know-how, Fern and Stephen have the show-how. Fingertips, now on video and DVD.
Let's go!
Little Red Tractor, he's king of the fields. Getting his job's done with Stan at the wheel. He's not the biggest, but he's a hero. Little Red Tractor, let's go!
Introducing the brand new Transformers Armada.
And let the games begin!
The brand new Transformers Armada series. Collect them now on video and DVD.
Every day when you're walking down the street, everybody that you meet has an original point of view. And I say, hey, what a wonderful kind of day. If we could learn to work and play and get along with each other.
Hey,
what a wonderful kind of day.
Hey!
If you like action, comedy,
drama,
wit, charm and repartee,
then you'll love
Bezel Brash, that's me, unleashed
for the first time ever on video and DVD
in all good stores and none of the dodgy ones.
Everybody go boom boom,
the happy faces and smiles all round.
Boom, boom.
Choose Bright Entertainment.
Everybody go boom boom.
Roll up, roll.
Watch Postman Pat and Jess the Cat in two brand new episodes and a feature-length special for the first time on video and DVD. Join in the thrills and spills when the circus comes to Greendale. Postman Pat Clowns Around, out now on video and DVD.
Postman Pat and Jess the Cat are back in four brand new adventures, out now to buy on video and DVD. Join Pat and Jess as summer comes to Greendale in the Ice Cream Machine, featuring four exciting new stories. Postman Pat and the Ice Cream Machine, out now on video and DVD.
Hi, my name is Emily Elizabeth, and this is Clifford, my big red dog.
Clifford needed Emily, so she chose him for her own. And her love made Clifford grow so big that the Howards had to leave their home. Clifford's the best friend anyone could know. He's the greatest dog ever, I really think so. Clifford's so loyal, he's there when you call. I love Clifford, the big red dog. So they packed up a family car, and the Howards left the city. They moved to Birdwell Island, had no many new friends there to greet Clifford and Emily. Clifford's so much fun, he's a friend to us all.
I love Clifford, the big red dog. Woo!
For my party, Charlie. This is going to be the best birthday I've ever had.
No problem. Everyone will love these newspaper sea captain hats.
Hoist anchor and trim the sails, first mate, Emily.
Aye, aye, Captain Charlie. We're off to search for a great white whale.
Woof, woof.
Make that a great red whale.
These beans in a paper cup will make great music.
Have you seen my morning paper?
Has anyone seen the bowl of beans I left on the counter? I was going to make soup.
Here's your newspaper, Dad.
And here are your beans, Mrs. Howard.
I guess we should have asked if we could use these things first.
I guess so.
Sorry. But you told us we could use things around the house for my birthday party decorations.
That's true.
We did. Woof, woof. I think it's wonderful that you two are making all these things for your party by yourselves.
Charlie and I are even making up the games.
We're making everything. Except the cake, of course.
I'm making the cake.
Emily's absolute favourite, chocolate swirl with vanilla icing.
Mmm, thanks, Mum.
And I'll get these leaves raked up nice and tidy for you.
That's okay, Dad. Clifford's going to take care of that for us.
Get started on that cake.
Great. Can I lick the bowl?
Ha ha! Jumping leaves is great fun.
Let's make it one of the party games.
Yes!
You have got to be joking.
No bouncy castle, no pony rides, not even a water slide. And you call that a party? Please.
All the games at my party are going to be made by Charlie and me, Jetta.
Obviously.
You don't have to buy stuff to have a great party. The important thing is to have fun.
Exactly. And you know what makes a party fun? Sparkle, excitement, pizzazz!
Pizzazz?
Pizzazz?
You know, something really special. I'm sorry, Emily, but what you've got here is just boring.
Oh, that's not true. We're going to Bob for apples and we have party hats and musical instruments.
Well, I wouldn't want to go to a party like that, and I don't think anyone else will either. I'm sorry. see you later, Emily Elizabeth.
What if she's right, Charlie? What if my party doesn't have pizzazz?
Don't listen to her, Emily. This party's going to be great. And we've made it all ourselves.
You're right. It's like you said, the important thing is to have fun.
It's also important to have friends. So we better deliver these invitations. We can ride our bikes.
I know a faster way. Oh, well, I have nothing better to do that day. All right, Clifford. Next stop is Jetta's house.
Why are you inviting Jetta?
She's my friend. She always comes to my birthday parties.
But she said herself she wouldn't want to come to a boring party like yours.
She did say she wouldn't want to come, didn't she? Okay, Clifford. We'll skip Jetta's house.
She's not inviting me.
Hey, hold it, you three.
It's Jetta. She must have seen us go past her house.
I think we hurt her feelings by not inviting her. Let's invite her now.
All right, if she wants to come.
Hi, Jetta.
Hello, Emily Elizabeth.
Jetta, I want to...
I hope you weren't going to invite me to your party.
Well, yes, I...
Oh, I'm so sorry, but I've got another party to go to in the city. An amazing party with a water slide and all kinds of pizzazz.
Really?
Uh-huh. So, thanks, but no thanks.
Oh, well, you don't need to worry about Jetta anymore. She's got another party to go to.
Yes, good for her. But I still wish you would come to ours.
Happy birthday, Emily!
Thanks, Mary.
Hi, Emily.
Hi, Vaz. Did you bring the bath I wanted to borrow for apple bobbing?
Oh, no! I've left it on my front porch. I'll go and get it.
Okay. Wait! I think Clifford wants to help. Thanks, Clifford.
Hi, Mac. What are you doing here? I live here. Remember? I just thought you'd be in the city at the big party with Jetta. Big party? Jetta's not going to any party. She's not? Nope, she's in the house, moping around with nothing to do. Really? Oh. I'll see you later, Mac.
Thank you so much, Clifford. Now we can bob for apples.
Great birthday party, Emily.
Yes, it looks like everyone is really having fun. What is it, Clifford?
He wants to show us something.
I think it's time to re-invite Jetta to the party, Charlie.
I think you're right, Emily.
Hi, Jetta.
Hello, Emily Elizabeth. I'm just waiting to be picked up for my big party.
Oh, Jetta, I was hoping you might change your mind and come to my birthday party.
Oh?
Mm-hmm. Because I thought about it and you were right. My party did need pizzazz. So I decided to add a water slide after all.
Did you?
Oh, a water slide? Really? Well then, I suppose I could cancel my other plans. Great!
I've got to hand it to you, Emily Elizabeth. You and Charlie really made this party into something special.
Thanks, Dad.
And the best part is, you thought of everything yourselves.
Jetta, it's a good thing you took my advice about adding a little pizzazz.
It was pretty good advice.
Thank you for inviting me, Emily Elizabeth. You're right. A homemade party can be lots of fun.
Everyone!
How about some birthday cake? Make a wish and blow out the candles, Emily.
Okay.
Happy birthday, Emily!
Oops, missed one.
Is a lot more fun when we share with our friends. That's why Clifford's big idea for today is sharing.
No, it's mine. It's mine. It's mine. Mine. I say it's mine.
What's going on, T-Bone?
I found this toy first, but Cleo thinks it belongs to her.
Not true. I found it and it's mine.
Maybe instead of fighting over that toy, we can all share mine.
Well, okay.
Great. Here you go, Cleo.
Here you go, Clifford.
This is fun.
Yeah.
When friends share with friends, everyone is happy. That's why Clifford's big idea for today is sharing. Emily Elizabeth, and this is Clifford, my big red dog.
Clifford needed Emily, so she chose him for her own. And her love made Clifford grow so big that the Howards had to leave their home. Clifford's the best friend anyone could know. He's the greatest dog ever. I really think so. Clifford's so loyal.
Clifford!
He's there when you call. I love Clifford, the big red dog. So they packed up a family car and the Howards left off.
I love Clifford, the big red dog.
Woo!
Emily Elizabeth would love this.
I'm going to find her. She's not here. Not here either. Emily Elizabeth could be. I better go and find her. Where is everybody? Maybe everybody went down to meet the ferry. I'll go and see.
Be careful, Pedro.
I am being careful, Victor.
The balloons! You've got them! Thanks!
You're welcome, Amy Elizabeth.
Clifford's going to love them.
Oh, thank you both. Oh no! It's Clifford!
It's Clifford! Pedro and I will hide the balloons.
Everything's under control.
Thank you, Victor. Thank you, Pedro.
Anytime.
Anytime.
I know you want to play, but...
T-Bone. This is definitely my best idea ever.
Your best idea?
Huh? Okay, okay. Our best idea. Just look at it, T-Bone. Doesn't it make you just want to dribble?
Yeah, it certainly does.
Where'd that come from?
want him to see this.
Cleo, I don't think you...
Shh.
But Cleo!
You'll give the surprise away.
So there you are.
Oh, hello, Clifford.
Hi, Cleo. What's wrong with T-Bone?
He had onions for breakfast. They give him awful breath, you know.
Oh. This is my new toy. Shall we play?
We'd love to, but... You know, I have to take T-Bone home so he can brush his teeth and gargle with mouthwash. So what if we just meet you in the park later, okay? Okay, see you, bye.
Okay. Well, good luck with the gargling, T-Bone. Perhaps there's someone to play with at the dunes this morning.
Where?
There he goes. Whew, that was a close one. Now all we have to do is... Hey, where's the cart? Huh? Oh, no. Why didn't you tell me?
But I...
Well, come on, let's go and get it.
Oh. This is the best birthday cake you've ever made, Dad.
It's for someone pretty special. After all, there's only one...
Clifford! What should we do?
Quick, hide behind the bush.
A close one, eh, Dad?
Yes, but I think we're going to need some more frosting.
No one here to play with. What a boring day. Nothing to do. Cleo and T-Bone can't play till later. Emily's busy, and no one else is around. Oh, boring, boring, boring. Hey! Perfect shot. Let's try that again. Woohoo! This is fun. See, playing alone isn't that bad after all.
Clifford!
Emily Elizabeth!
Clifford!
Woof, woof!
Where is she? Where's Emily Elizabeth?
Clifford!
There she is!
Clifford! None of us could play with you all day, Clifford. I hope you weren't too bored. We were all just really busy making sure your birthday party was the best ever. You were surprised, weren't you?
I think that means yes. Happy birthday, Clifford. You're the best dog in the whole world. On the hottest day anyone could remember, Speckle and his friends just couldn't stay cool. Not even in the paddling pool. Everyone wanted to play and have fun, but it was just too hot to do their favorite things. Then Speckle thought of a way they could play and stay cool. He brought over some ice cubes and dropped them in the pool. Then started a game of catch the cube. Then, twirling the garden hose, Speckle made a watery skipping rope. Soon, the grass was all wet and slippery. And Speckle led the way in a water slide across the garden. Giggling and joyful, the friends all agreed that Speckle's new way of playing was really cool. The end. Wasn't that a great story? Isn't reading fun? And this is Clifford, my big red dog.
Clifford needed Emily, so she chose him for her own. And her love made Clifford grow so big that the Howards had to leave their home. Clifford's the best friend anyone could know. He's the greatest dog ever. I really think so. Clifford's so loyal.
Clifford!
He's there when you call. I love Clifford, the big red dog. So they packed up a family car, and the Howards left the city. They moved to Birdwell Island and their many new friends. They're to greet Clifford and Emily. Clifford's so much fun, he's a friend to us all.
I love Clifford, the big red dog.
On the tables. Wow!
Hey! Hey! Hey!
Uh-oh.
Oh, I can only imagine what they're up to today.
Potluck party.
Another party? What a surprise.
Is
is going to be great. We're going to learn some new games and listen to all kinds of music, and everyone's bringing their favourite foods.
I can't wait to come.
Are you coming too, Mr. Bleakman?
No, thank you. I like my Saturday nights just the way they are.
Every Saturday night, Mr. Bleakman has pork chops for dinner, does a little gardening, paints, then heads off to bed.
It sounds nice, Mr. Bleakman, but wouldn't you like to try something different tonight?
No, thanks.
Okay, but you don't know what you're missing.
Don't worry about me. I'll be just fine.
Miss Lee brought a wonderful Chinese noodle dish.
Oh, let me try some of that.
Mmm, that's good.
You want to try some, Cleo? That?
It's Portuguese salt cod. Victor and Pedro brought it.
Yum! That sounds good.
Yoo-hoo! I'm here!
Violet, I'm so glad you came.
Mr. Bleakman still won't come?
Well, you know Mr. Bleakman and his Saturday routine.
Pork chops, gardening, painting, bed.
Oh, so I just left him some pork chops and tootled over here myself.
Hi, everybody. Look what I've brought.
Wow, that looks amazing. Gosh, I've never seen anything like it. It's delicious. Can I eat it?
Spicy salsa. It's my grandma's recipe. Doesn't it smell great?
Oh, Clifford, be careful. These chilies are hot.
What's that?
You kids must be smelling my spring rolls with peanut sauce. Who'd like to try some? My first customer. Well, what do you think, T-Bone? I think he likes it.
Oh, let me
first!
Mr. Bleakman got a whiff of these, he'd have to come to the party.
What a great idea, Charlie.
Huh?
Just follow me.
What is that?
Is he smelling it yet?
I think so.
More wind, Clifford.
Really good.
Hi, Mr. Bleakman.
What's that smell, Emily Elizabeth?
Spring rolls with peanut sauce. Want to try some?
No, I'll just stick to my pork chops, thank you.
Well, okay. But you're welcome to join us if you change your mind. Some way to get Mr. Bleakman to join us.
Maybe he's afraid to try something new.
Or maybe he just doesn't like parties.
Or he could just be shy.
Yeah, sometimes I feel shy when I first come to a party.
You do?
Yeah, but once I get there and start talking to people, I always feel much better. This is my favourite music. I never feel shy when it's playing.
Go on, Vaz, put the music on. Maybe Mr. Bleakman will like it too.
Okay, here goes.
Oh, this is great! you want to dance. It really does.
Show.
One late afternoon, as the sun was setting, Speckle and his friends thought their fun was over for the day. Then they noticed their shadow stretching along the ground and making funny shadow shapes on the wall. It was so much fun, they decided to make their own shadow puppet show. Luna became a graceful swan. Darnell was a royal king. Speckle, Reba and Robbie teamed up to be a big, friendly giant. It was great fun! But then the sun finally disappeared and took their shadows with it. Until tomorrow. The end. Wasn't that a great story? Isn't reading fun? And this is Clifford, my big red dog.
Clifford needed Emily, so she chose him for her own. And her love made Clifford grow so big that the Howards had to leave their home. Clifford's the best friend anyone could know. He's the greatest dog ever. I really think so. Clifford's so loyal.
Clifford!
He's there when you call. I love Clifford, the big red dog. So they packed up a family car, and the Howards left the city. They moved to Birdwell Island and their many new friends. There to greet Clifford and Emily. Clifford's so much fun, he's a friend to us all.
I love Clifford, the big red dog.
Through a video camera.
Let me look, Baz. Here.
Clifford looks really good in the movies.
It was nice of your dad to let you take his camera to Jetta's movie watching party, Baz.
Yeah, I thought that after we'd watched the movies, we could make one of our own.
Sounds like fun.
I brought my favourite superhero movie to watch.
I brought Dog of Denmark.
I love that movie.
Let's watch that one first.
Let's hurry to Jetta's so we'll have time to watch them all. Welcome to my party, everyone. We've got lots of seats, popcorn and juice, and a TV set to watch our favourite videos on.
Great, let's get started. I'm gonna sit here.
I'll sit here.
Whoa. I like the beanbag chair.
Is everyone happy?
Yeah, let's watch a movie.
We want to watch Dog of Denmark first, Jetta. Is that okay?
We all love it.
Well, I had thought that as it's my party, I would be the first one to pick a video. All right. What do you want to watch?
The Jetta Show! What's the Jetta Show?
That's what my mum calls are home movies.
Home movies?
Wait till you see my first ferry ride. Oh, look, aren't I adorable?
You look really cute, Jetta.
I think I'm going to like this tape.
Yeah, me too.
Hey, look at the dolphins! They're so clever.
Don't worry, if there's only a little bit of them, then we get back to me. Don't you just love this?
Yeah, love it.
It's great, Jetta.
Just great.
Wow, look at that. That's the third Jetta show tape they've watched, Mac. Are there any with you in them?
Of course. There's one whole one called The Mac Show. I'll show it to you one day if you want.
Great, one day. But right now, should we play a game together?
Okay, what do you want to play?
I don't know. How about chase?
We play that a lot.
Let's do something else.
All right, like what? How about jump hose?
Jump hose? I love jump hose.
Do you want to go first or should I?
You turn for me first, then I'll turn for you.
Okay.
Ready?
Uh-huh.
Okay, Clifford. Here goes. Yes.
Oh, that was such an exciting spelling contest. My mum made me a special spelling bee cake and everything. Oh, watch how my mum gives me a big slice. Isn't that great? See how daintily I'm eating it. Oh my gosh, it was such a big piece of cake, I could hardly finish it.
What are you laughing at, Emily?
Here's me taking my first ride in my dad's new...
What's going on?
What's so funny? We were just looking at the dogs.
I'm going to record it.
You're supposed to be watching my tape. You've missed the last part.
You mean it's the end? Great! Now let's watch Dog of Denmark.
Not yet. We have to watch all the parts of the Jetta show. How many parts are there? 25. This one's my favourite.
Wait a minute, Jetta. You said we were going to watch lots of different videos at this party.
It's true, Jetta. You told us each to bring our favourite one. I know, but I'd rather watch mine.
I don't really want to watch any movies. I think we should make a movie of our own.
Yeah!
Great! This is a movie watching party, not a movie making party.
Come on, Jetta, it'll be fun.
Why don't we vote on it? That would be fair.
Yes. Let's vote. All those who want to make a movie, raise your hand.
All those who want to stay in and watch Jetta's home movies, raise your hand. It's 3-1. We go outside.
Great.
Okay. Not coming. Come on, Jetta. No, thank you, Emily Elizabeth. You're not going to play. I'm going to stay here and watch my home movies alone. Come on and try it. If you don't like it, we'll all come back in and watch a movie with you, okay? No, thank you. Well, your choice. But if you change your mind, we'll be outside. Don't worry, I won't change my mind.
Here I am with the famous explorer Emily Elizabeth Howard. What are you looking for today, Emily Elizabeth?
Today we're on the trail of the really hard to find big red dogosaurus. See his footprints?
He is big.
Come on, let's follow his trail.
Wow, this is great!
Charlie! I remember that pie eating contest was so messy!
Hey, I wonder what they're laughing at.
Oh, well, it doesn't matter.
Famous explorer Emily Elizabeth, do you think we're getting close to finding the big red dogosaurus?
Oh, yes. We're very close.
Could that be him?
No, that's not the big red dogosaurus. That's the small blue triceradog.
Great!
Good job, Mac.
Oh, why does it look like they're having so much fun? Why couldn't they have fun like that doing what I want to do? I'm going to ask them.
I think we're getting close now.
Just hope this hard-to-find big red dogosaurus is friendly.
Uh-oh. He looks pretty friendly.
He is friendly.
But that doesn't look so friendly.
Hello, Jetta. Are you going to be in the movie now?
It's really, really fun.
Why didn't any of you like doing what I wanted to do?
We did like it, Jetta, but then we wanted to do something else. And now it's fun making a movie.
What makes this silly game so much fun anyway?
It's fun because we all have something to do in it. Emily and I are the actors.
And I'm the director.
Even Clifford and Mac have something to do in this game.
It's just more fun when everyone is part of the game instead of just one person telling everyone what to do.
Was I doing that?
Sort of.
I'm sorry. I just thought everyone would love doing what I told them to do.
So, do you want to be in the movie, Jetta? You could be an explorer with me.
Well, yes, please. But I don't want to be an explorer. I want to be the beautiful jungle princess who rescues everyone from the big red dinosaurus.
Sounds good to me.
That sounds great.
Yeah, but somebody better tell Clifford he's supposed to be scary.
Everyone, let's play.
Clifford and I know that it's nice when friends play together and nice when they work together too. And that's why Clifford's big idea for today is work together.
What a great day.
Yep, but it's time to go home now. We better clean up.
It's going to take forever to clean this up.
No, it won't. Not if we all work together to get it done.
That didn't take long at all.
And it was kind of fun, too.
It's always nice when friends work together. It gets the job done in no time at all. And that's why Clifford's big idea for today is work together. neighbour. And this is Clifford, my big red dog.
Clifford needed Emily, so she chose him for her own. And her love made Clifford grow so big that the Howards had to leave their home. Clifford's the best friend anyone could know. He's the greatest dog ever. I really think so. Clifford's so loyal.
Clifford!
He's there when you call. I love Clifford, the big red dog. So they packed up a family car, and the Howards left the city. They moved to Birdwell Island and had many new friends there to greet Clifford and Emily. Clifford's so much fun, he's a friend to us all.
I love Clifford, the big red dog.
Something smells good. Wow! Something looks good too. I'm gonna ask Cleo if I can have a bite when she gets here. Just a little bit. Wow, this is great. Maybe I'll just take one more bite. Nothing.
Smells like something really good was in there.
Yeah, well, maybe there was.
Hi, guys.
Is everyone ready for the park?
Yeah, let's go to the park.
But wait, first I want you all to try my new dog food. I saved some so you could taste. Hey, what happened to my food?
What do you mean?
It's gone, that's what I mean.
Wow, someone ate every bite.
Who could have done such a thing?
Maybe a crunch crook took it.
Crook?
Of course. What else do you call a dog who steals from another dog?
T-Bone, did you see anyone suspicious around here?
I might have seen a dog running away down the street.
Which way did he go?
Well, I think he was heading for the tourist dock.
We must find him and make him apologize to you, Cleo.
Oh, right.
Perhaps we shouldn't. He was quite big.
Bigger than Clifford? I don't think so.
Come on, let's start looking.
All right.
Right behind you.
Oh, boy.
I'll find that crunch crook if it takes all day. All right, team. Spread out and smell for anything unusual.
Anyone? The only crunch cook around here is me. Who's in there? Is someone in there?
Find something.
Perhaps
it's the crook. Careful. Never know what a dog like that might do.
Yeah, especially one stuffed with my crunch.
Stand back, team. I'm gonna blow his cover. What in the world are those? Well, they're stuffed all right, but not with Cleo's crunch. I'll just put these back.
You know, maybe we should just give up. I mean, it was only a bit of dog food.
It was my little bit of dog food, and that dog shouldn't have taken it without asking.
Oh, yeah.
Come on, everyone. Let's continue the investigation. Right.
Let's go!
Where are we going, Mac? Every crook needs a good hideout, Clifford, and these caves are the perfect thing.
Wow, you really know your stuff, Mac.
Think he might be in there? Hello?
Hello?
I think he's there. It can't escape now.
Let's corner him.
Oh, wait!
Whoa!
What?
I don't think you should go in there.
Why not?
Because you what, T-Bone?
Because I'm the one who... Who wants to go in there alone?
You do? That's really brave of you, T.
Yeah, well, maybe I can talk to him, get him to apologise or something.
I'll go with you.
That's all right, Clifford. I'd rather go alone.
Well, okay, if you want to.
Be careful, T-Bone. Dogs like this don't like to admit when they've made a mistake.
Yeah, I know. Right, I'm going in.
I wonder if T's found anything. I wonder if he's all right. I wonder if we should go in and check on him.
I wonder if you could stand still for a minute. You're making a hole in the ground.
Sorry. It's just that I'm worried about T-Bone. Maybe we should go in after him. He really wanted to do it alone. You're right. I just hope he's all right.
Oh, no. I've really done it now. Now I'm never going to be able to tell Cleo that I'm the real crunch crook. Huh? I know! But I have to tell her. I just wish I'd told her the truth in the first place. Oh well, here I go.
Time for you to stop.
I have to agree with Cleo. I can't help it. I'm worried about T-Bone. Perhaps we could go in after him now.
Yeah, let's go.
T-Bone! Are you okay? Where's the crook?
Did you find him?
Yeah, I found the crook.
I want to talk to him. Where is he?
He's right here.
Huh? What do you mean, T?
I mean, I'm the crunch crook. I'm the one who ate your dog food, Cleo. I'm really sorry.
Why didn't you just tell me before, T-Bone?
Because I was afraid to at first. I thought you'd be cross. And then I wanted to tell you, but it kept getting harder and harder. But I promise, from now on, I'm always going to tell the truth, right from the beginning, even if I think someone might get cross.
You know, T, I probably would have been a little cross, but all I wanted was an apology. Once I had that, I'd forget about it.
Are you cross with me now?
Yes.
You are?
Yep. But now, it's forgotten.
Huh? Great!
Come on, everyone. Let's go back to my house and try my new dog food.
Great! Yeah!
Today's story is Speckle and the New Ball. One day, Reba was showing Speckle her new red ball. She bounced the ball so high it almost touched the clouds. That is a great ball, said Speckle. It sure is, agreed Reba. In fact, I bet Robbie would like to play with it too. And she walked away, taking her new ball with her. I thought she wanted to play with me, he sighed. He was even a little sad. But Reba can play with whoever she wants, Speckle thought. And he went back to his sandbox. He began to build a sandcastle when Reba's ball suddenly landed at his feet. Speckle looked up and saw Reba and Robbie. Are you ready to play ball? Asked Reba. Speckle realised that all along, Reba had wanted to play with Robbie and him. Okay, he yelled back, and the three of them laughed and played and had a wonderful day.